When it debuted, the 4G wireless we have today allowed people for the first time to hit the road and explore unknown places with only a smartphone for directions. When 5G arrives, it could enable driverless cars to take us there as well. 5G stands for fifth generation mobile networks or wireless systems. It's insanely fast and can accommodate a lot more connected devices. But the reason it's being called revolutionary is because 5G will allow connected devices to speak to each other as well as people.
Right now we're living in a world where really it's a one-way experience.
That's Bloomberg tech reporter Ian King.
The network talks to your phone, you look at your phone and access data, then you send something back to the network. What we're being told about 5G is that really for the first time we're going to see machines communicating with each other over mobile networks in a meaningful way.
5G could end up being 100 times faster than what we have now, with speeds that could reach 20 gigabits per second. In plain English, that means downloading a full-length HD movie in seconds. 5G will also increase total bandwidth, which we will need in order to accommodate the growing Internet of Things. We're talking about the class of devices like internet-connected refrigerators, thermostats, dog collars, but 5G will enable many, many more.
Things like your utility network factories, where machines are just sat there, not connected at all. Suddenly they're all going to be connected. Suddenly we're going to be able to have real-time monitoring. Other things like cars, like utility poles, like your light, you know, the light poles.
But perhaps the biggest advance will be a huge reduction in communication lag time, known as latency. A network of driverless cars will need the speed of 5G to ping each other multiple times per second to avoid collisions. Near instantaneous data transfers could allow doctors to perform surgery remotely with a robotic scalpel. So how will all this work? First, you need to improve network density.
And that's just a fancy word for saying you put more towers out there. What we're being told is that's not actually the case with 5G.
The idea is 5G will not only use the existing mobile spectrum, but also tap into higher frequencies called millimeter waves. Millimeter waves can carry more data, but only travel short distances. This may mean you'll see a lot more of these base stations around town. And the new towers may have as many as 100 antenna ports, compared to about a dozen on 4G cell towers. So when will we get 5G? Getting 5G ready is expected to cost providers $275 billion over 7 years in the US alone. Look for the first 5G service to pop up in big cities sometime in 2019.